Hello everyone, this is Krushna Prasad from Mindfire Solutions. Today I am going to demonstrate to you the session ID analysis and session hijacking using a very popular tool WebScarab, which was developed by OWASP. So as you can see, WebScarab is a proxy tool which only task is to intercept requests and responses and to modify them in between a web client and a web server. And as you can see, it has lot of plugins like web spider, cross-site scripting, carriage return line feed attack, and session ID analysis, fuzzer and compare. There are lots of plugins. So today I will be taking you through session ID analysis plugin, where a user can analyze, a secure tester can analyze the cookie values, and he can generate a pattern, the graph. From the graph, we can guess that whether the pattern that the cookie is following is random or it is following any certain guessable pattern. Okay, so for that, I have designed one servlet page. Let me start the service. Okay, so it has been started. So as you can see, it has two fields, one is first name, one is last name. So when you put any values into this field and hit submit, it will create two cookies. You can see here, it has been created two cookies. One is J session ID, one is week ID. J session ID follows a random pattern, whereas week ID follows a certain guessable pattern. So when I will analyze these two cookies in my tool WebScarab, you can see the pattern and the statistics. So say for example, this week ID follows an some increasing guessable pattern. As you can see, when I'm refreshing, you can see the value is changing 5, 6, 7, 8, like this it is changing. Okay, so what you can do is, when you go to the summary tab, you can get all the requests that are that has been intercepted. Okay, so say for example, I want to it has a set cookie column where you can see that in this request, in certain request, whether the cookie has been getting set or not. So when I'm going to say for example, I want to analyze the 13th request, so I will go to the session ID analysis. Okay, so we go to the 13th, I will browse the 13th request. As you can see here, the cookie is getting set, and say for example, I want to fetch 10 samples. I fetched it, I went to analysis tab. So you can see here, I fetched 10 samples. So when I am going to the visualization tab, here you can see it has three columns. One is value, one is numeric, and one is difference. So value is the exact cookie value. Numeric is deduced from this value column. OWASP uses one algorithm called per position based conversion algorithm, which converts this string to this number. It adds this value as a string and it converts this string to a numeric corresponding numeric value using this per position based algorithm, and it also shows the difference between two numeric values. You can see the difference is always one. So whenever the difference is constant, that means it is following certain pattern which can be guessable. Okay, so if I'm going to visualization tab, you can see the graph is linear graph. Okay, so that means it is following some pattern which can be guessable. But when I'm browsing say the J session ID cookie, like this one, the request is ID is 5th request. So when I'm browsing the 5th request, so here you can see on the 5th, I want 50 sample. Okay, so it generated 50 sample. You can see all the three columns are random. We cannot even guess the pattern in which the values are getting, the session ID values are getting increased. So it is random. So if you go to visualization tab, you can see the pattern is random. So you cannot guess. So every application should behave in this way. So all the cookie values should be random. Okay, so like this, there is a very famous tool called was web goat, using which you can also, it is a vulnerable application using which you can get some vulnerable in the application and you can attack into it. So to I would like to show you the session hijacking. So for that there is a good tool which has been used, is called jhijack. But I have designed a simple page. I would like to show you that. Let me start the service. Okay. I'm copying the context path. So here you can see the cookie value, how it is changing. So when I showed you in the last cookie ID pattern, so here you can see the pattern was like 11, 12, 13, and it missed one cookie ID called 14. So there are some guessable patterns like this, which will use some sequence to generate cookie values, and they will miss some values in between. So the target user needs to find what is that cookie value. So basically jhijack is used here. The task of jhijack is it in between some reg, it used to inject those cookie values to the application and try to check how the application is behaving. So here I have designed a simple page because of which it increases the cookie value by 1. So 14th has been missed. So if I am going here, see the cookie value is now 3, 4, 5, wait. One second. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, then it got 15. That means the 14th is a hidden cookie value which you can inject. It is a simple application which I designed for demo. So you can see here when I'm injecting 14th, when I'm refreshing, it is taking this and it is accepting this value. So this is a simple way where you can hijack session. So I will be coming up further tutorial regarding session flaws. So that is it for the day. Thanks.